Oh wait, I think it's already being recorded.
We're both recording it so that we have a backup in case, you know, things happen.
I make sure I didn't like kick you off or something.
I mean, weirder things will have happened in life. How are you, friends? Good? Good. I love to see your faces. I know we do have a couple people on who are not sharing their screen or not turning on their camera. You guys, just so you know, that is totally fine. You are more than welcome to just keep it to yourself. I will get that you will have a blank screen, so I will not see the looks of angst on your face. However, we're just going to party together today. We have a fun setup. We're going to get a little bit more dynamic with our work today. I was hearing a request for some arm work, so I'm going to give you that. Yeah, and we're going to get some glute work. Really, it's going to be full body because I'm extra, so why not? Yeah? So for my setup, just so you know, I have my mat laid out. I have my chair right at the edge of my mat, yeah, facing forward. We're not going to use it right away, but we do need it handy. And then I have a closed-loop TheraBand. This is either or. You can have either one or neither and rock with hand weights. That's totally fine. Either a closed-loop TheraBand or I have like a long open-ended one. Literally either one is fine. And if you want to just opt for hand weights or bottles of water or cans of food, you're more than welcome to do that. If you're like, forget it, gravity works well enough for me, that is also totally an option. The only thing is with the chair or stool, whatever you're stepping up on, you do want to make sure that it is sturdy enough for you to stand on and you feel safe, yeah? If you decide not to step up on the chair or the stool, that's totally fine. You'll just be stepping forward doing the same motion except without the incline. And again, all that is fine. Take what you need today, leave what you don't, yes? If you have anything going on in your body that would affect your movement, definitely type to me in the chat box at the bottom of the screen. Let me know what's going on so I can make sure that we're working safely. That being said, if I can't see you, I can't correct you, right? So if you choose to leave your camera off, that is totally fine by me. Just know I won't be able to actually physically see your body and make those corrections as you're moving. So it is up to you, but I feel like we're ready. Can we get started? Good. Bodies are good today. Energy is good. I like it. Okay, we're gonna start laying down on our mat, and you just want your TheraBand nearby, and the chair will be in front of you, but don't worry about it for right now. Yeah, just go ahead, find your way to laying down. Yeah, facing up to the ceiling. Yeah, and we're gonna just have our feet flat on the floor and knees bent. We're rocking with a little hip hop vibe today, so hopefully y'all are okay with that. So we're just gonna start with a nice, easy pelvic warm-up. When we lay down, our arms come long by our side. We're gonna have our palms down to the mat this time because I want you to walk those fingers down and away a little bit. You're gonna feel your shoulder drop away from your ear. And then I want you to leave that handprint right where it is. We have a neutral tail, neutral spine, which means we're exhaling the ribs flat on our front body. So the bottom portion of the ribs comes toward the top portion of our hips, kind of like we're flexing. And then from there, the pelvis stays nice and neutral, which means you have a little grape-sized space underneath your lower back. All that is great. That is your neutral spine. That's how we exist in space. That's what we're finding here. So you should feel the backs of your hips on the floor. Your feet and knees are at least hip distance apart, so maybe even heel toe them a little bit wider. We're gonna stay here and breathe. We're gonna take a nice deep inhale through the nose. And then as you exhale through the mouth, think about wrapping that torso a little tighter. So think about a little belt cinching tighter around your rib cage. Inhale, the ribs go east and west. And exhale, just close the rib cage down like you're trying to hold something in there. Yeah, and see if this affects the pelvis. The answer is it shouldn't affect the pelvis. Pelvis should stay heavy. We're just waking up the upper abs and the top of the transverse abdominis. So inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth, let it go. Good. This time we're going to adjust the pelvis consciously, yes? Feet and knees hip distance apart, feeling off four points of each foot in the floor. Take an inhale. Where you are as you exhale, all I want you to do is smush a grape underneath your lumbar spine, your lower back. So don't lift your booty. Don't even squeeze your glutes together. Literally just push down through your lower back and your lower belly. Inhale, you're going to take a nice deep arch. You're going to push your booty back like you're at a party. You know what I'm saying? And then exhale. Push it down, yeah? So now we're taking a little forward and back mobility into the spine specifically. starting with the pelvis. The pelvis is kind of driving the car on this one, yeah? Everything else happens as a result of what's going on down here. So inhale, reach the tail back. Exhale, push down. It's like you have a grape underneath your lower back and you're just smushing it, trying to make some wine. Inhale, reach. Exhale, push. You're just gonna go for two more. Inhale, and exhale. Last one, we're gonna stay smushing the grape. So inhale, push that booty back. Yeah, and then exhale, smush the grape and hold. Stay there. Make sure that we're, again, not equating the glutes into the equation. We're leaving them out. All I want you to do is think about your heels. Pull your heels toward your seat. Make those hamstrings fire. You see me pull forward on that mat when I do it? Hold that. Smush the grape and breathe here. Keep that activation going. Don't quit. Just keep pulling with the heels and smushing the grape. Breathe for six. Five. This is a little burn. Four. Three. Two. One. Give it a little release. Take a little shake it out moment. Side to side. We're back to our neutral tail, neutral spine. From here, we're going to work with the knees, a little windshield wiper. So take those arms a little wider than your mat. Take the rib cage down, the chest down. Take an inhale where you are. As you exhale, drop the knees to the right. Now, we have a tendency to start to stack up the feet and the knees here. Don't do it. Literally just let them be this staggered position. You're going to start to feel a little stretch through the outside of that hip on that left side. As you exhale, smush the grape to bring the knees up. So use your exhale. Push down to come up. And then the knees will go to the left. You'll feel that gorgeous stretch through that top quad. We'll get a little external rotation on that bottom left glute. And then as you exhale, smush the grape. Bring it on up. Inhale, drop the knees. Exhale, push down to come up. On your own breath, your own time, right? Because you're the only one who's controlling that breath right now. Exhale to push down. The more you push down into the floor with your lower back, the easier it will be for those knees to just float up right where they belong. And notice if those knees are rolling in or out, you want them to stay directly over those ankles or heels. Last one each side, and then I'm going to give you my favorite pretzel stretch, yeah? We take the knees to the left. We exhale, bring it right back up. So this one, you're going to want to go with my words and not what I'm showing you because I'm not mirrored for you, okay? So identify your right leg. I think we might have done this once before. Take that right leg and cross it over your left. Okay, so now the right knee is higher toward the ceiling. You're gonna lift your booty up, bring it to the right side of your mat, and walk your left foot over. So now we're kind of on an angle going toward the bottom right corner of our mat. Our arms are out nice and wide. All you're gonna do is stay in that little twist and drop those knees to the left, taking your gaze, your eyeballs, over to the right. So this is a nice deep supine twist, first thing, to stretch out that lower back, that piriformis area, and those glutes. You could breathe it out here if you need a little less. Push down to the floor and bring the knees up a little bit. Make sure it feels good. You don't want to feel any pinching or pain in this, yeah? If you got a little more, you could take your left hand into the hip flexor, like right in that little crevice, and push down, giving it a little space. You're just pulling the head of the femur down a little bit. And then we inhale, bringing the hand back to the floor. Exhale, bringing the knees right back where they started, the gaze up to the ceiling. We come to center with everything, and then we unwind. Yeah? We're going to take the left knee now over the right. So identify that left leg. Bring it all the way over like you're sitting in a chair, chilling. We lift our booty up. We bring it to the left side of that mat, walking the right foot over to meet it. And then we drop the knees to the right. Your gaze, your eyeballs go over to the left. You feel that nice deep twist from the crown of your head down to the tailbone and everything in between. So the reason we move the hips over is so that our spine actually stays in a vertical line. So right now your pelvis is directly underneath your shoulders, underneath your head. Breathe it out here. If you need to take that moment for extra space in that hip flexor, feel free to take it. As you inhale, you're going to bring your hand down to the floor. Exhale, smush the grape to come right back up. You're on an angle, it's awkward. Unwind yourself, lift those hips up, and come on back to center. Beautiful. So give those knees a hug for a second. Rock it out side to side. I got a few more little warm-up stretches for you. We're going to kind of go around the world. You're going to roll on over to your right side. Yeah. like I'm at the beach. And I'm gonna lay on my arm, that's more comfortable. All I want you to do is grab your ankle with your left hand and take a nice little quad stretch. And I'm literally just chilling down here, like I'm on the beach. But we do wanna lift the belly up a little bit so we're not like full splat. Yeah, we still wanna wake up our muscle groups. So right now my left hand is grabbing my left ankle, so it's all on the same side. Yeah, this feels good, but pull that belly up a little bit. Good, and then shake it out. You're gonna go ahead, bring that foot down to the floor. You're gonna grab now left hand to right foot and pull back. So I'm switching it out, yeah? It's like a little crossbody stretch. My left hand grabbing my right foot now. And I'm just chilling. Good. When you're ready, give it a little release. We're gonna come to hands and knees, 4-point stance, yeah? 4-point stance. So hands go right underneath your shoulders, knees go right underneath those hips. We have a nice wide stance. We're gonna take a couple cats and cows here. So channel your inner yogi for half a second. Take an exhale, push thoracic spine to the ceiling, take a look at your belly button, and then inhale, arch your lower back, lift your gaze up, draw your shoulders out of your ears. Exhale, top of the tail, deep progression through a deep wrap in of that transverse abdominis again, and then inhale, release it into your cow. You do need to keep your shoulders out of your ears in that cow, yeah? I know we all just want to dump into it and feel great, but we still got to make those lats fire. Just a couple more right here. Just for three. Find that neutral point in between two. Just acknowledge where that is for you. Somewhere in the middle. Every body is different, but we do want to feel what is the most stable. In fact, let's go ahead and find it now. Find your flat back. Feel like your lower belly is lifting up a little bit. Push up out of those shoulder blades. Tuck your toes underneath you, yes? So now bottoms of my toes are on the floor, so my hypothetical pedicure that I may have gotten never, right? Lift those knees up. The pedicure is nice and safe because we're using the bottom pads of the toes. Feel that little knee hover burn. You should feel your quads. You should feel your shoulders. You should feel your belly. You attach the head to the spine, looking about 2 inches in front of your fingertips. We want to wrap that belly up and in. Lift out of the floor. For six. Little burn. Five. Four, three, two, one. Let's set the knees down and breathe. You can sit on back to those heels. You can stretch those arms out. Finding some extension through your shoulders, through your back. Good. From here, we're gonna go ahead back to that 4-point stance for a chest opener. Yeah, so go ahead back. This time we're gonna take our left hand to our head, so our elbow's gonna be out. You're gonna exhale, you're gonna close the book, bringing left elbow towards your right, looking over that right shoulder, and then inhale, twist and open toward the ceiling. Go ahead, exhale, close. Inhale, twist and open. This is opening up that upper back of yours. It may feel a little bit more like work than stretch, but it is there for you, yes? We'll go for four. See if you can get a little more rotation every time. Three. Can you support yourself using your belly? Two. Last one here. We're gonna go ahead, find that deep rotation, and then bring that hand down to the floor, immediately going into the right side. Right hand to your head. Exhale, close the book. Inhale, twist it open. Take your gaze with you. Take your eyeballs with you in the direction you wanna go. That's gonna be a theme for today, yes? Find that inhale, twist and open. The reason I have you inhale as you twist is because that's when the diaphragm lifts up toward your rib cage, and we actually get more stretch that way. Last one. Find that deep opener. And then go ahead, bring it all the way down. We're gonna lay on our left side now to stretch our quad. On the right, I'm just gonna flip to face you, yeah? So all you have to do is lay on your side. Set that arm down, bring those knees in front of you. You're gonna take your right hand, your right foot, and find a nice deep quad stretch there. You wanna try to pull your heel towards your butt, and you wanna lift up your lower belly. Nice and easy. And you're just relaxing your neck down. So see if here is, you automatically like wanna lift your head up and wanna see what's going on camera. Like literally don't worry about it. Just relax, because you know it'll make you sweat in just a second. We'll breathe it out here. Let's release it, bringing that right knee forward a little bit. This time weaving underneath the top leg to give the opposite, the left ankle a little pull. And I like to pull my leg back. So left knee goes back behind me. Nice and easy, breathing it out, getting that glorious external quad stretch. So the shin should go to the outside of that left quad toward the floor. We breathe it out for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Give it a nice little release. Take a moment to shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. And we are gonna grab our band. You can have your close-up TheraBand or your open TheraBand. It really is up to you. If you're holding your open TheraBand, you're gonna be holding it about shoulder width apart, and you're gonna have a little pull out on it, okay? If you have your closed loop TheraBand, we're gonna put it on the outsides of our palms. So that's the activation, yeah? So we're gonna come to laying down. It's time to get into those abs a little bit. We're gonna face our chair and lay on our back. So our gaze is up to the ceiling. For right now, I do want you to keep your feet on the floor. I just want you to feel what's gonna happen, okay? So you have your hands either through that loop, giving it a little pressure outward, so wide, yes. You can even start by inhaling where you are and exhaling, just pulling that band a little wider. Inhale, little release, exhale, pull wide. Even if you're holding either end of that open end of TheraBand, you can pull out on it, yes. Good. From here, we're gonna keep the tail neutral. We're gonna start to add in a little crunch if it's there for you. If this is ever too much, just ditch the band and do the ab work, yes. Inhale where you are, start to pull out on that band. Exhale, wherever you tap is fine by me. Inhale to come down, little release. Exhale, push out on that band as you crunch. Keeping that spine nice and neutral right now, but finding a little C-curve through the top spine, just for a moment, yeah? Feeling that the outsides of the arms are working all the way into that lat connection into your core. So we're exhaling to come up, we're inhaling to lower down. We're just gonna be here for 5. We're gonna be here for 4. Try to get it wider than your legs. 3, 2, come on up and hold. We're gonna start to pump wide, wide, wide. So my arms are going open, open, yeah? And for me, I know my left side is not my strongest side, right? I'm trying to put this in a nice way. So I gotta minimize my right arm taking over the work and make my left do just as much. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bring it all the way down. Reach it back, just a little burn to wake up that upper body already, right? Go ahead and scoot yourself just a little closer if you need. We're gonna put our heels on the chair now. Our heels are gonna go on the chair. And we're gonna go ahead and hold on to that band, but this time we're gonna rotate our palms in toward each other. So it's like clap your hands position, yeah? Go ahead and push out on that band a little bit, take it inhale. As you exhale this time, smoosh the grape with your lower back and then crunch up, tap your kneecaps or your shins. Inhale, head and chest down. Exhale, crunch. And this time, rather than pushing out and in on that band, you're trying to keep pressing out the whole time. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, lower. Yeah, if you got a little more in there, and you could use a little bit more as you go down, you have a moment to extend those arms back. Feel the chest open. Exhale, crunch. Reach forward. So you're going all the way back as far as you can go. Inhale, exhale, right back up. And again, if this is too much for you with the band, ditch it, yes? There's plenty of work to be done outside of this, I swear. For 5, 4, 3, 2, we're gonna come on up and hold on this one, so come on up and hold, pulse it out. Out and wide, 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 there it is. For 4, for 3, for 2, red light, hold. Keep pressing into that band. Extend your right toes out and then bring it down. Extend your left toes out, bring it down. Extend your right toes out, keeping that lower back pushing down, correct? Correct. Bring it down. Left toes out, down. Right toes out, hold. Left toes out, hold. Pulse it forward, 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 four. 3, 2, 1, bring it all the way down. And breathe. Ooh, I'm burning in bad places. Good job. So we're gonna work here. We are gonna go ahead, hold on to the outside of the band this time. And it's just gonna slide my thumbs through. Yeah, and your job is literally just to hold it steady. This is just a guide for you that your arms should not be going wider than this, if that makes sense. Yes? Take your right leg up to the ceiling. Take your left leg up to the ceiling. Now the chair is below us. We're not using it right now. It's just gonna be a guide for us. Take what's called a Pilates V. So turn your feet out into a little triangle and then point your toes. Your knees should be going in the same direction. Now, we're gonna be pushing straight up to the ceiling, straight out from those shoulders. So take an inhale where you are. Exhale, straight up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, straight up. And your job is to hold those legs nice and steady right now with your heels squeezing together. If this is too much, you can always set the feet down on the chair. That's totally fine. Yes? This is just the full extension. For four, three, two, come on up and hold. If you need to bring the head down, that's also fine. Take your right leg down toward the right side of the chair. Bring it right back up, little Pilates V. Like those heels have magnets on them. Left leg goes down and around, right back up. Two legs, down and around, right back up. Now, there are modifications for this. You can bend the knees, going out, in, double out, in. It's there, yes? If you don't wanna do either of those, you can go right, up, left, up, yes? It's a little less of an upper belly work or lower belly work, but it is there for you. Now, if you are taking the full, think about the four points of the box of the body. Those are your shoulders and your hips. Right now, the shoulders have dropped down, so it's the bottoms of the shoulder blades that are the bottom two points, and then you have the hips, right? So you really wanna anchor those four points into the ground so that when you open your legs, nothing adjusts. You're just getting that adduction and abduction, waking up that pelvic floor. Last one in this direction. And then we'll breathe it out. Yes, bend it in. Set the band off to the side. Keep it accessible for half a second. If you wanna grab the knees into the chest, pull them wide into your armpits and rock it out side to side. You're more than welcome to do that. Good. From here, oh my gosh, was I literally being that mean? I literally was being that mean. The band is gonna go around your quad. So if you have the open one, you're gonna have to tie this one. Yeah, it's gonna go right above the knees. So when I come up to show you, my kneecaps are here, and I have like an inch or two above the knees, yes? So we're gonna go ahead and we're just gonna drop our knees to the right. So it's almost like that windshield wiper we did in the beginning of class. Your hands come to your head, your elbows go nice and wide. Now my knees are to the right. My right hand is gonna end up on the floor just like that. All I want you to do is lift that left leg off of the bottom right, yes? Take an inhale where you are. Exhale, little crunch up, oblique crunch. Inhale, lower. Your job right now is to hold this band steady. Yes, hold the band steady. So we wanna parallel the shin to the ceiling. Yeah, or I should say the outside of the shin. We wanna be able to set our cocktail right there, or mocktail, or tea, or coffee, whatever it is for you. Now, if this is enough for you, great. If you got a little bit more, as you go down, the leg will extend out, still staying in the same horizontal plane. Exhale, crunch, bring it in. Inhale, extend, chest drops. Exhale, crunch. For six, five. We won't be here for long, we're just getting some obliques real quick. Three, two, let's pulse it in. Pulse it in. And in, let's go for eight, seven, six, five. Biggie would be proud. Three, two, and one. Bring it on down, breathe it out. I'm gonna have you rotate and flip around, yeah? So this part is gonna be fun. Take that band, bring it down to your ankles. Yeah, trust me on this one. So I'm flipping around, my head is going toward the chair. And we're actually gonna start using that chair as an anchor. So give yourself a little bit of room. We're gonna work that lower belly, but we're gonna get some really nice activation through the spine. Go ahead and hold onto the legs of your chair or even a little bit higher on the base of it, it's up to you. Go ahead, bring those legs up to tabletop position, smush the grape, but feel that band. You want to push out on that band. You want plenty of space between your knees because you're going to inhale where you are. Go ahead and extend those legs out above 45. As you exhale, up and over, feet come to the chair, push out on that band, roll it all the way down. Modifications. Get rid of the band. That's phase one. Phase two is you can take your knees, just bend your knees. Inhale, lower a little bit, exhale, momentum up to roll all the way down. Yes? So the whole motion for you will be up and down. And you just want to find those moments where literally you're feeling like you're suspending your hips in the air. Yeah, I do want to see what's going on with this for sure. Oh, I got so many more faces. Good. Now, I think everybody needs to slow down a little bit, and you're going to be so mad at me about that. But I want you to take double the amount of time on the way down as you are taking on the way up. Yeah? So exhale to bring it over. Inhale slowly to bring it down. Yes? Good. Now, notice that when you pull on that chair, it's wanting to move, right? Don't let it move. Use it as your anchor. You're going to feel a moment where you go from wanting to pull to wanting to push. Let those fingers be long on those legs of your chairs so that you don't have the tendency to want to grip it and pull it, yeah? Good, try for four.
Don't forget to breathe. Three.
Two more. Oh my gosh, y'all, great job. Last one, go ahead, roll it all the way in. Bend those knees into your chest, move that band right up to those quads. This time we're gonna go ahead, drop our knees to the right. We're gonna go ahead and lift. Wait, am I doing the wrong way? No, we're gonna drop the knees to the left. I was backwards. Yeah, we're facing the other way this time, that's okay, so the knees are up, then you come over. You go ahead and twist your top body. That left arm is gonna come down to the floor. You lift the right leg off of the bottom. We're gonna work that oblique on the right side now. Take an inhale, exhale, little crunch. Inhale as you lower, exhale, little crunch. Your job right now is just to stabilize that top leg.
I do see your comment, I'm coming right for you.
Cool. Okay, and then if you got a little bit more in there, you can go ahead and extend your top leg as you lower down. Inhale, exhale, crunch. Bringing the knee into the chest. Inhale, lower, exhale, crunch. Yeah, chin away from chest. Yes, you are going to have to drop it a little bit, but I don't want to see like a double chin moment. Yes, for four. Three. Two. Come on up and pulse. We have eight. Seven. Six, five, four, three, two, and one. Bring it all the way down. Roll onto that back. Give it a nice little hug. You have completed your around the world abs. You're like, hallelujah. Good work. Roll it on up. The band is, we're going to play with that a little bit more. This time, I'm sorry, this is not going to be very nice. The band comes out. We're going to do some bridge work with our feet on top of this chair. The band is going to go between your knees, and your job is to hold it there. Yes? I joke, except I'm not joking, when I'm in the studio with you guys, that if you drop the band or on the roof or wherever I am, we have extra reps. So I'm going to switch it so I can see everybody. Have a lie on your back. Put your heels on top of that chair seat. Put the band between your knees. Pretend it's something valuable. Uh-huh, so bring your feet together and your knees together. And that way the band can be thin like paper and just be held between your knees like you have a sheet of paper between your knees. Does that make sense? Cool. So feet together, knees together, heels on top of that chair, neutral spine, arms long by your side. Close that rib cage and smush the grape. Take a nice deep inhale. Let's flex our feet, toes up to the ceiling. Exhale, one piece. Lift your hips up to the ceiling, keeping your chest down. Chest down. Good. Lead with the booty. Booty first. Inhale. Tap that booty all the way down. Exhale, lift it right back up. Good. Take a deep exhale. And then inhale as you lower, booty taps down. So nice long spine when you lower down. Give me a little bit of a J-Lo, Beyonce, Kardashian, Cardi B moment. Yeah? So your butt should hit the floor, but your lower back should not. Yeah? So we're adjusting that spine. And then we're squeezing in on those knees so that our adductors, our inner thighs, start working. And we feel a little back extension as a result. The more you push down through your chest, the more you're going to get out of this. So think about your chest being heavy, like there's a little anvil on it. And then your hips lifting up to find a nice long line of engagement. Inhale, booty taps. Exhale, lift. Good. Let's go for six. And up. Five. Four. Three. Two. Pulse it up. And up. And up. And up. Go for four. Three. Two. Hold it up. You're holding that steady. Draw your shoulders out of your ears. Lengthen your neck. We have four, three, two. Bring that booty all the way down, starting all the way over. Inhale. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Squeeze those inner thighs. Don't drop that band. Just four. We'll move quickly. Three, two. Hold it up. We're going to start those pulses this time down. Down, down, down. Just for four. Three, two, one. Lift it all the way up. Make it look easy. For four. Squeeze inner thighs. Three, two, and one. Bring it all the way down. Good. Release it. Oh, that was a burn real quick, huh? You can extend those legs if you need. Yeah. Okay, so this time we're going to hold on to the band again between our hands. My palms are facing forward toward my kneecap. So it's the same position that we started in, and I'm just going to merge the worlds a little bit. This time with your feet, take that Pilates V, heels together, toes apart. Put your heels on that chair so your toes are aiming up and wide. Yeah, so it's like a nice easy triangle. Cool. Now this time we're holding that band, same way we did earlier. I want you to protract those shoulders, retract your shoulders, pull them back into the floor. Give me just a little pressure on the band, nothing too crazy, something maintainable. Now, if you're protecting anything in your back, keep working with that hinge. If you're feeling good, take an inhale. As you exhale, pull your heels toward your seat, tuck the tail, start to peel on off the floor one vertebrae at a time, feeling those glutes squeeze this time, ribcage staying down, chest away from chin, then roll down one vertebrae. One disc at a time. Getting a little back massage, feeling those hamstrings work and those rotators. Release your tail back at the very bottom. Exhale, tuck the tail. Roll it on up. Inhale, roll down. Think 90s R&B body roll. Bit by bit, piece by piece, like we're in a music video, yes? Release that booty at the very bottom and then rinse and repeat. I'm coming to check in on you. Now, the more you pull out on that band, the more stable your arms are going to be. So it's going to be a little bit less spaghetti arms up to the ceiling and a little more activation through the shoulder girdle. Because while bridges get you into your back body, your front body is working for stability. What are you feeling, Billy Joe? Knee? Go parallel instead of turn out.
It's just killing me when I'm doing that. I don't know if I'm doing something wrong.
You can either try pointing your toes instead, or you can take parallel instead of that V. We might have to talk about that in a little bit though. Yeah? Let's go for four. Or you can even bring your feet down to the floor as another option if it doesn't help you. Yeah? Two more. Good. Come on up and hold. Hip pulses up and up. Let's go for eight, seven, nice, six. Flex those feet, unless we discussed otherwise. Three, two, hold it up. Find your happy place. Now, your hands are in those bands, palms facing forward, right? Give it a little pressure. Inhale, bring your arms back toward the floor. Exhale, bring them forward. Inhale, arms go back, biceps by your ears. And then exhale forward. If you have a wall right behind you, you can bend your elbows a little bit. That will help you too, yeah? I know. For six. So keep the head down, the hips up. Yeah, so we're just working mobility through the shoulders. For three, whammy. Let's go. Two. Y'all, she's been putting up with me for like 2 years at this point. Called out. And one, bring the arms right back where they are and roll those hips all the way down. Dare I ask, are you burning? Did you feel it? Uh-huh. Okay. So go ahead, take a figure four stretch. That is right ankle over left knee. Flex your right foot to begin and then thread your hand through to that thigh. Give it a hug and then you can extend the leg up to the ceiling from there. If you need a little rock and roll through your spine, you're more than welcome to take that as well. Take another breath. And then we'll switch sides. So we'll take that left ankle over your right knee. Start with that figure four, thread the arms through, give it a hug. And then when you feel ready, go ahead, extend that leg up to the ceiling. Good, take what you need. Flex point that foot if you need to stretch out that hamstring. And then we give those knees a big fat hug, wide or narrow. We rock side to side, forward, back, whatever you need. We're gonna get up and over. So make your way to vertical, roll to your side. If you wanna put on shoes for this next part of our workout, you're more than welcome to do that. If you prefer doing step-ups and stuff with shoes on, I totally get it. We're gonna be working with our stool and our chair, Yeah, and we're gonna start with a little burst of cardio. So make your way to vertical. Fix your pony if you need to fix your pony. Grab some water if you need to grab some water. Y'all know what jumping jacks are, yes? We are gonna be starting with jumping jacks. I'm gonna lift up my screen so you can see me and I'll talk you through the whole sequence. Remember the sequence because we're gonna be doing it later too. We'll start in 3, 2, 1. Nice and easy. Just jumping wide and narrow, letting those fingers tap above your head, working through the feet and the knees. We're ready for it. We warmed up that belly. We got our back extension. No problem. Continue with your jumping jacks. What's going to happen next is we're going to come to our chair. We're going to be using our chair as if it were a gym bench. So you're going to hold on to that chair on either side. Walk to the left side. Bend the knees. Hop, 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 hop. Yes? Get going into that. Make your way over to your chair or your stool. Put your hands on either side. Walk to one side of your mat. Bend those knees, hop on over to the opposite side. Your mat is lava. Don't jump in the lava. Remember that game from when you're like 10? Try to kick your own butt, so bring your heels towards your seat. You could take a pause on either side. You don't have to go right away. Yeah? That's okay. No stress. Kick, 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 kick. Let's go for 5, 4, 3, 2, back away, follow me. You're gonna stand nice and wide. External rotation, so wide Pilates V. Bend your right knee. Left hand taps down to the floor. Stay low, switch. Tap, 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 tap. One knee is bending, one leg is straightening. Stay low, this should bring the heart rate down. 8, 7, 6. In 5, you're just going to walk your hands forward, finding a plank. 3, 2, and 1. Walk it forward. Find yourself in a nice little plank. Hold. You can walk down to those forearms if you need. Lift up, drop that tail though. Squeeze those glutes. Nice and easy, breathe. Shoulders out of your ears. Good. 4, 3, 2, walk your hands to your feet to your hands. Roll it on up. We're starting the whole thing over again. Now you know what you're doing. So we're going to smooth it out, get right into it. Start those jumping jacks. Nice and easy, jump wide and narrow. Make sure your knees are going with you. So most of us need to push our knees wider when we jump wide. Yes, nice, beautiful job for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, walk it on over, get started, hop, hop, try to find a moment where you float, for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, walk it back, find that wide external rotation, bend one knee, tap, switch, 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 stay low. Booty back, long spine, for 8, 7, 6, 5,
6, pick up the pace. 4, 3, 2, walk it forward. Stay nice and wide with that plank position. Push those shoulder blades wide. Hold. Squeeze your glutes. Deep inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Again, inhale. And exhale. Last one, inhale. Exhale, finish it all the way up. Walk those knees down. Split them, take a child's pose. Breathe it out. Woo. Grab a sip of water. Roll it on up. You okay? Give me a thumbs up. She's on the floor. She's like, I'm fine. We're good. Okay. Come on up to standing. We're going to face our chair.
Yeah, the band stays off to the side for now. This one feels kind of good. So, the hardest part of your whole situation right now is you're going to be stepping onto your chair or stool. So stand up, take a little squat. So when you squat, booty back, chest up, like there's another chair behind you. You're just going to sit on, stand up, and then step down, down, squat. So you're taking a squat at the top and at the bottom. Now, in between those, you step down, down, squat. Transfer your hands forward, finding a high plank. Mountain climbers for 8 to come on in and start all over. So you're going up, up, squat, down, down, squat, mountain climber for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes? Let's go. Up, up, squat, down, down, squat, run, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes? You don't have to go that fast. Take your own breath, your own time. Yes? Make sure that form is perfect so when you squat, your spine stays nice and long. Your knees should not cover your toes if you look down at the floor. Yes? Make sure you're shifting weight into those heels. Yeah, Billy Joe, a little bit more weight in those heels. And I want you to push your knees a little wider. Yes! Get it. Yes. So, Kester, I don't know your first name. I'm sorry. I'm calling you by your last name. Like we're part of a volleyball team or something. Yeah? When you sit down in your squat, you got those gorgeous long legs. You're going a little too low with your shoulders. So you get here, which is bob, and then you go here. So I want you not to collapse over your thighs. I want you to stay up. Yes? Cool. And Wemmy, you know what I'm going to tell you, right? Get those heels down, girl. Get those heels down. I see them. Good. Up, up, squat. Good. You're going to be here for 8.
Yeah, let me take the ass back to the club.
7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. Wherever you are, you drop down to the floor. Yes, find a high plank position. Bend those knees, step or hop all the way up by your feet. Booty stays low. Lift your torso, lift your arms, bring it down and back. In, up, down, back. In, up, down, back. In, up. So if I were being a real jerk and I was in the room with you, I would be standing right over your head, making you reach for my hands above your head when you find that wide squat. Take some external rotation. Stay low so that we're targeting the glutes here. We're targeting the rotators. 5. Don't come to standing up. Keep the knees bent. Just lift the shoulders up. 4. Good, y'all. I know. 3. Chest up, Robin. 2. Chest up, there you go. Last one, come on up and breathe. Good? We're still friends? That may have been the wrong finger, y'all. We're going for thumbs. Thumbs, please, good.
Grab some water, you did awesome. We're gonna take a little cardio break and work with our band for some arms, yes? And I'm going to be coming to weird angles so you can really see everything, okay? Cool. So, from here, lifting you up.
We're starting with, you're going to go ahead and put that band around your wrist. You're going to lift your elbows up to shoulder height. And what's going to automatically want to happen is this. So really hold those arms parallel. Elbows right in front of your shoulders. You're going to open the right arm and close. Left arm and close. So you want to really isolate into the back of your body. Curly, awesome. Amazing. Good. So it's like almost like a door. One side is opening and closing, yes? If you're feeling gangsta, the band isn't too tight for you, you can take both. You may end up kind of hitting yourself in the chin, but it's okay. Yeah? Back, forward, back, forward. Nice and easy. Breathe it out now. This is a good way to unwind. Bring that heart rate down a little bit. Shoulders stay down out of those ears for four. Three. Are your elbows dropping toward your waist or can we leave them up? Two. Last one, we're gonna find this activated position. Pulse it up and up. Up. You should feel your shoulders. You should feel your biceps here. For eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Bring it all the way down. You're just gonna move the band forward so it's in your palms now. Yeah? Your elbows hug in tight to your waistline. Now my fingers are facing forward toward you. My hands could clap here. Stand up nice and tall on your two feet. You can take a little space or a soft bend in your knees. You're gonna open out. So the motion, I'm gonna show you without the band so I can be dramatic. All you wanna do is keep your elbows into your waist and go out. In, out, yes? This may not be a large range of motion for you. Doesn't need to be. This is external rotators of your shoulders. They're really, really small muscles that we don't often target, yes? We're gonna finish this round up. We're gonna do a little cardio burst, then we're gonna come back for a little more. So keep the band with you. Good, if you wanna take one at a time, you're welcome to. For four, three, I'm gonna move you down a little bit. Two, last one, bring yourself back toward your chair. Set the band down. We're gonna walk to the edge of the mat. We're gonna do my favorite, which is long jump. You're gonna stand at the edge of your mat, you're gonna get low. You're gonna jump as far forward as you can. Get low, walk back, 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 back. Get low, hop forward, walk back. Two, three, four. Jump, land, walk back. Nice and easy, toe ball heel as you walk back. Really work through those feet as you jump. Nice and easy. Gentle lift of the heart rate again, yes? And we have our band nearby for safekeeping because we're gonna need it in a second. Four, make sure you're not slouching. If I already told you that you need to keep your shoulders up, I'm talking to you now. Yes? Four, three, two, and one. Come on up, grab that band. Now do as my words are saying on this one. Because this is another one that if you do what you see, it can get a little complicated. My left thumb has the band, yes? I'm gonna grab my right shoulder with my left hand. So that's what I look like. Now my right hand goes through the band, if I could grab it, yes? Sit down into a baby squat, push those triceps back. Bend it in, push it back. Feel that tricep flex. So you really want to feel that little V on the back of your arm. Push. Deep inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. We're going to be here for five. Four. Three. Two. Go ahead and straighten it. Release. We're going to keep the left thumb in the band. Just reach that arm up to the ceiling. Palm facing toward your head on this right side. Pull behind your head and resist. Pull behind your head, resist. So if you were to bend this elbow, you're not gonna whack yourself in the face. You're going behind. Yes, getting those lats. For six. We got one more little thing on this side, then we'll switch it up.
five, shoulders down, four, feel that underneath your armpit, three, those lats, two, one, go ahead and release it all the way forward. This time you're gonna step on the band with the ball of your right foot, yes, ball of the right foot. You're gonna get into a deep squat, so shift weight into those heels. Remember, my knees aren't coming forward. They're right over my ankles. From here, I'm supporting myself with the left hand. All I'm gonna do is low row pull back. Inhale, release down. Low row pull back, release down. Yes? So we're getting those bigger, bulkier muscles along your traps, your rhomboids, and your serratus. So when I'm going this way, the band is coming to the outside of my knee. And I'm supporting in and out on that quad, just like so. First six, five, four. We're gonna switch into the left side in three, two, one. Go ahead, release it all the way down. Link that band over your right thumb. Put your right hand on your left shoulder. Left hand into the band. Soft bend those knees. Tricep press. And bend. Now I'm trying to leave my fingers nice and long. One thing I noticed on me on the last side is that I was here, right? You get that long tricep when you extend through your fingertips. It also protects the wrist and the elbow. Yes? Good. We'll be here for about six. Belly up and in. Five. Four. Three. Two, train that arm, we release it all the way in. We send that right arm up to the ceiling. We have our left palm facing toward our head. We're gonna work those lat pull down. So pull down, up, down, up. So this is still work for that right arm because it has to stabilize. And it might be a little tired because we worked it out already. So just find that core connection because if you think about it, arms don't lift themselves. Yeah, neither do legs. Everything starts between the tops of your shoulders and about mid-thigh. So when somebody says use your core, we're not talking about the pit of the belly. We're talking about the majority of your body. For three, and then we'll do that low row in two. Last one, we're gonna extend it all the way up to bring that glute down underneath the ball of your left foot. We're gonna find that gorgeous neutral spine. So remember, no slouching, no tucking, yes? We're not a GIF. Toot that booty back, chest up. Pull low row, palm in, and extend. Pull back, getting that upper body. So at this point, we're still sweating, but the heart rate has come down, yeah? You really wanna feel stabilizing through your breath work. Exhale to pull, inhale as you push. Yes? For five, four, two, make your way back if you're not facing your chair. Last one, release that band. Set it off to the side. What do you know? Perfect position for some bench hops. Shall we go? In four, three, two, let's go. Up and up. Kick yourself in the booty. Let's go for eight. You won't be here for long. Seven. Use that core. Six. Five. Four, three, two, and one. Come on back. Breathe it out. We're in our last little push. Grab some water if you need. Wipe yourself off if you need. I want to come in and check in. Are you good? That arm sequence though, right? Okay, I like it. So this next part is all stability. Slow down your breath. Find your control. Yes? So we're going to come to standing on our chair. And you're gonna face so that your left foot is on the chair, the right foot can dangle off the side. I'm gonna lift you up here. So, come to standing. My head might get cut off, but who needs my hand anyway? My left leg is gonna be on the chair. My hands are gonna come to heart center. Prayer position for control. Walk toward the edge of your chair, and then bring the right leg out. If this work that's happening, stabilizing, isn't all you need, live and breathe. Yes? You can even play with the straight leg forward, yes? If you got more, baby bend your left knee, press. Now it is maybe 2 inches or 3 inches. Your heel has to stay down. You see my knee working to stabilize. We want the hip to do all of that work. So spread your toes. 8, 7. Breathe it out. Look at something in front of you that's not moving. If you look at the floor, you're gonna go to the floor. 4. Tall spine. 3. Lower belly up. 2. Good. This time we're gonna go ahead, step all the way down. You're gonna take a little turn out in that left leg. You're gonna hold on to that back of your chair. If you don't have a back on your chair, give me 3 seconds, yeah? Otherwise, reach that right arm above your head. You're gonna stay low, tap, down, tap, down, yes? Tap, down. Now, if you don't have the back of the chair to help you, you could just come up, bring the knee in and step down, or you could do a sumo squat into a push, yes? That's all there for you, yeah? Now, if you have the back of your chair, you have the stability, let's go. In, tap, in, in. We have 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on down, everybody. Sit on your chair toward the front. Bring your fingertips to the edge of your chair so your fingers are facing forward. Walk it forward, inverse plank. If this is enough, live your best life. If you got more, march it out in, reach. Eat, in, reach. In, reach. In, reach. Just 4. I know we're tired. 3, you're almost done, you can do it. 2, and 1. Bring it all the way down. Bend the knees, bend the elbows. Down, up, down, up. If you want a little more, as you push, you lift the hips. Whatever you need. For 4. Almost there. 3, 2. Last one. Bring it all the way up. Walk your feet in. Bring the booty back. Take a moment to shake it out. We're going to stand on our chair facing the opposite direction so the left leg can dangle off. We can work stability on that right. So come on up, same exact activation. This one is parallel, so you walk toward the edge. Hands to heart center, dangle the left leg. Find your gaze on something not moving in front of you. Bend the knee, press it out. Bend the knee, press it out. Think about working from the inside out. Nice and easy. Which side is easier? Take that inventory for yourself. Spread those toes. 6, 5. And then we're gonna get low in 4. This will be the sumo squat or the knee coming outside of our body. Lateral mountain climbers. 2, 1. We bring it up to step all the way down. We find some external rotation. Hold on to the back of the chair, extend your left arm up to the ceiling. Bring it in and tap. In and tap, stay low. Stay low, that right leg should burn. Nice and easy for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step off all together. Sumo squat, this one feels good. Face your chair, hands to heart center. Wider than the mat, external rotation. So just how we were doing those tabs, right? Get low in that hip, feel them stretch. Come up, bring the leg around. And opposite direction, yes? It's like a sumo wrestler. If it's too much to get the leg over the chair, step back, same motion, knee. Down, knee. Spread your toes. No chill right now, keep going. Last 5 minutes. Good. Oh yes, for the tall spine and range of motion. Dang, am I being too easy? I might be too easy. I saw that with me. For 5, you got it. 3, 2, last one, last little bit here. This one is also to bring the heart rate down a little bit.
sit on your chair. We're gonna start with the left heel lifted, full right foot on the floor, yes? Sit up nice and tall, little arch in your lower back. Stand up, squeeze your buns, keeping this left heel lifted, sit right back down. Up, up, down, down. So this is prep for a pistol squat. If this is enough for you today, keep going. Yes? You got a little more of the advancement. Activate that leg in a tabletop. Come on up. Finding stability through both sides of your body. And steadily bring yourself back down. So I don't want to see this happen. Yeah? Stay on top of yourself. Highest activation, yes? Extending the leg out. Inhale. Stand up. Keep it up, keep it up, keep it up. Sit. Yes? Whatever works for you works for me. Get going. Good. Four. And then we're immediately going to do the other side. Three, so we stay in work mode. You can even extend your arms out if you'd like. Two. Come on up and hold. Find a balancing moment if you haven't. Bringing that foot down. Sit all the way down on your chair. Start with that right heel popped, yes? Forced arch on the right. Pull left foot down. Heart center, hands prayer position. Come on up, squeeze them glutes. Sit down, don't rock back. Yes? Nice and easy, and then when you feel ready, if you feel ready today, we add on that little advancement. Finding a gorgeous tabletop. Feeling that whole left leg work. Nice and easy. Don't hold your breath. It gets harder if you hold your breath. If you want to go for that extension, go for it. For four. Three. Two. Good. This one, come on up. Find your balance moment. That foot comes down on the ground, hip distance apart. Walk down those legs. Walk it all the way forward. Plank position, high plank, please. Lift your right heel, lower. Right, left heel, lower. Tap, lower. Tap, lower. Four. Three. Let's go, let's go. Two. One. Go ahead, walk it down. Split those knees, child's pose. Big toes can come together. Last little thing, and then we stretch. And then that's it. You're done with me until next week. The thing is, remember our sequence that we started with? Remember? Jumping jacks, bench jumps, lunge taps. Come on up to standing. We're doing it for a minute. Push. I will cue you through everything. Don't stop moving, yes? We'll have the little peak of our plank activity at the end. Jumping jacks starting in four, three, two, let's go. Jump it out. You got it, Tara, you got it. Drop those shoulders, you got this. Make it look easy, girl. I feel you. More than you know, actually. I know, but we gotta put on a happy face because our body remembers it, yes? Nice and easy. This should feel like a breeze. Five, four. We're gonna make our way to our bench. Two, let's go. Hop, don't stop now. Go side, 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 side right away. Let's go. Up and over. We won't be here for that long. You're already halfway through. Let's go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hop off that bench. Wide external rotation. Wide stance. Bend that right knee. Tap left hand down. Switch, 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 switch. Nice and easy. Get low, get low. Faster. Tap, 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 tap. Lower that booty. Drop those knees. Good. For six. Almost there. Five. Four. Three. Two. Highest plank challenge yet. And we stretch, yes? Hands to the floor, toes to your chair. If this doesn't make you feel good, feet on the floor, hands on the floor. Nice and easy. Stand wide. Squeeze those glutes. left. Side plank activation. Come on through center. Walk it back, right hand to the center. Rotate. Side plank activation. Yes, you have to walk a hand to the middle of your mat, or you won't be able to balance. Whew, let's go. Squeeze those inner thighs when you drop your heels. There's more assistance for you there. Four. Good, last little push, you got this. Three. Nice, y'all. Two. Last one, find your plank. Pike those hips up, really at the very end, y'all. Get that booty up, pike those hips up, downward facing dog. Melt those heels down, pedal out those feet. Right, left, right, left. Y'all did all of that and then collapse at the last 2 seconds? Really? Good. Walk the hands to the feet. Take a big old bend in the knees. Drop the shoulders down. Heavy torso. Hanging over those legs. Yeah, so we're wide. Bend those knees. Rock the torso side to side. Nice and easy. Release those arms and roll it all the way up. One vertebrae at a time. Last little stretch for that upper body. If you have to go, I understand. If you could stay for one last thing for 3 seconds, come with me. Right arm up to the ceiling, palm up. Left ear to left shoulder. Bring your hand to the opposite side of the head. Just pressure, and then you start to bring that right arm down slowly. You're gonna feel the points where things start to open up. It feels a little icky. Stay in that spot. Breathe into it. You might feel it through the heel of your hand. And then when you lower it all the way down, you can relax that right arm, release that left hand, come on up. Left hand, palm to the ceiling, right ear to right shoulder, right hand supports. Start to slowly bring it down, 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 down. When you find the icky parts, you stay in them. Relax the jaw, relax the face. Relax that left arm down. Release the right hand. Come on up. Roll those shoulders back and down. For three. For two. And one. You guys did it. And you made it look good. Well done, you guys. You earned a great dinner. A whole lot of water. Yeah? You're welcome to unmute yourself. I know some people had to bounce out. This will be posted. You're very welcome. I see the chats. Not at all. No big deal, Kayla. Check in with yourself. Make sure how you feel tomorrow is how you want to be feeling. If you ever feel too sore, like you need a little assistant to sit on the toilet, or you need it's hard to lift your arms above your head, you know how I mean. You have to hold on to the back and like lower yourself. I've been there. That's all I'm saying. Yes, that's too sore. Yes, if that's you tomorrow, then we went a little too hard today and we maybe used less resistance next time. But I mean, y'all looked really good and you were taking those corrections. So I think you'll feel really good tomorrow. Yeah? If you ever have any feedback, feel free to hit up Wemmy, hit up me on Instagram. I'll type my handle in there. And I will see you next week for our final week of the four, right? That's nuts. Amazing, though. You guys are killing it. So thank you so much. I'm typing IG in here. If you ever have questions, feel free to hit me up. I answer them all. Yes? Thank you guys so much. Have a good week.
A question for you about my knee.
Yeah. Yeah, let's talk about it.
So
wait, hold on 1 second, okay?